Had I not met Thorpe that awful day, I think I would have probably been in a British team eventing or show jumping or something, for sure.
Politicians knew all about Thorpe and Scott, Bessel says.
Hello, my name is Norman Scott and I live here at Shilston Farm. I've been here for 35 years. After the Thorpe trial, I came here to Devon to live, and I just love it.
Good evening. The magistrates in the Thorpe case have heard that senior politicians knew all about Mr. Norman Scott's claims that Mr. Thorpe and he had a homosexual affair. And they knew it years before Mr. Scott stood in court and said it publicly.
I just, you know, said I wanted it all to finish. And he said that a great friend of his was the director of public prosecutions and I couldn't harm him in any way. And that made me very unhappy and very angry because I felt that our relationship was just based on the fact that he would always be all right.
Mr. Thorpe and three other men, Mr. David Holmes, a former deputy treasurer of the Liberal Party, Mr. George Deakin and Mr. John the Missourier, are charged with plotting to kill Mr. Scott. They all deny the charges.
My family were very... I don't really know how to explain it. We were very different, all of us, and I was definitely very different. All I cared about was horses, even from an early age.
Come on.
And it caused awful problems in the family because nobody in the family, my mother or any of the others, were at all interested. And it was my great passion, and that's all I ever wanted to do.
Good dog. Hello.
Today, Norman Scott lives in a rented cottage on the edge of Dartmoor. He has retained a love of horses. In fact, it was through horses that he first met Jeremy Thorpe.
It always says I was a stable boy in a riding stable. I wasn't. I went. My mother paid for me to go with two horses as a working pupil to this man so that I could go around badminton horse trials.
Badminton. There they were, the beautiful trophies just waiting to be won. Easier said than done.
And he was paid for me to be there. But he called himself the Honourable Vanderbreck de Barter and turned out to be Norman Vater, a coalface worker's son in Wolverhampton. And had, you know, and he just was a complete bankrupt and a liar. But of course we didn't. But he was a great friend of Thorpe's. They'd met years before or something. And that's how I met Thorpe. Thorpe came to stay with him. You know, the judge, everything was picked deliberately to destroy all of the prosecution witnesses. And it was an appalling, it wasn't justice at all. I was fighting for my life, my decency.
Thorpe was to delegate the entire unsavory business to his close friend and former best man, David Holmes. He used two middlemen to recruit Andrew Newton, the unprofessional hitman, an airline pilot prepared to do anything for a laugh.
It must be quite hard for young people to hear me say this, but I was just, as I've said before, totally involved with horses. I had sort of relationships with girls, as young boys do, and I had no idea about homosexuality. I didn't know what it was, and when I went to Thorpe for help, because, you know, Van der Vaarte had taken my insurance cards and things, so I couldn't get jobs. You had to have, in those days, you had to have an insurance card so you could unemployment benefit, all of those things. And Thorpe wouldn't do it for me, wouldn't. So he kept me as a sort of, he kept me on a leash, as it were, and kept in trying to get him to get my, to let me have my insurance card. But he never did. And of course, he raped me, which, you know, sounds pretty ghastly, but that's what happened. And it totally, that completely destroyed me. I had a nervous breakdown over it. So, yeah. You know, I've lost my wife, my son. My son hasn't spoken to me for 33 years. So, you know, all of that is because of this wretched not having the money, the insurance card. Because when I was married, when Benjamin was born, we had to have maternity benefit, you know, because I'd been modeling, but we still, the husband needed to have an insurance card with paid up insurance for her to get her maternity benefit. And of course I couldn't get it.
Jeremy Thorpe may not be the next occupant of number 10, but you never know.
It never crossed my mind that Jeremy Thorpe would be this person. I understood he'd help me and be somebody to respect. It was an appalling thing to do.
Jeremy Thorpe was swamped by congratulation telegrams. Good luck to him in his new job.
Because there were five different attempts to kill me. I do believe that the young, which is so extraordinary, the young have a totally different concept, you know, idea of what gay is. I really do. But my grandchildren are, well, they're just wise beyond their years, and this they're not ashamed of my homosexuality, and well, if they should be ashamed, which I don't think they should be, but so many are, and so many laugh and all that ridiculous thing. But no, I think 16-year-olds are so much more rounded now than they were when I was young. I mean, I was incredibly naive. And was for a long, long time.
Hudson.